Miro African Television. If you are joining this channel for the first time, this is Miro African Television. Miro African Television is not an organization nor a group. It's just Miro. When looking at Miro Africa, you see yourself. And we are not biased. We hit the bullet at the right place. Many may love us because of it. Many may hate me because of it. But that is Miro Africa for you, you know. So the only thing you will do for me is to click that button of subscribe. And there is one small bell after subscription. Click on that bell so that you will be getting notification whenever I am on air. And I will still be doing videos that will be going on Patreon. So today's program got to go this with a paragraph. Another question: should Nigeria be part of the free trade agreement within African nations? This question was thrown in, and I sat down and tried to watch and read the brain of Peter Obi on this question. Peter Obi fold my hand. He fold my hand on this side. Let me put asterisk so that I won't. I would like to talk more on this. You know, free trade agreement is a very large project, very powerful project that need very large fund to develop and work into it and make sure that every components are treated and ratified before tendering it for people to start signing into it. And those countries in Africa that are promoting this free trade agreement doesn't have the fund to feed themselves. Where did they get that money to push for free trade agreement? Who is financing this free trade agreement? Somebody is working from the behind the scene to promote this free trade agreement within Africa. Ask yourself why and who should be funding those things. Let me give you 5 seconds. Maybe you will give me a very nice answer. Because free trade agreement took Europe years to ratify, years to develop, years to work towards it. They didn't just jump into it and made it immediately. It took them time before cross borders, ratify things, put things the way it will suit them before they jump into it. But Peter Obi criticized Nigeria. Why they are not into that agreement? Why didn't they sign it? My question is, why do we keep on rushing in signing agreements? International agreements. Nigeria never even look into it. There are ones that Nigeria is supposed to do referendum for Nigerians themselves to decide. Our elites will just rush in and put their pen and just go their way. And tomorrow, Nigeria will start crying. So on free trade agreement, I would disagree with Peter Obi. Peter Obi, on this area, you fell it. You fell woefully. You failed woefully. Because it depends. I use the word, it depends. The reason why Peter Obi is supporting this thing. Maybe those that are financing this free trade agreement are also financing Peter Obi and Atiku to take over power in Nigeria. Be watchful. Be watchful and be warned. I have never had this thing that I'm trying to say here now in any platform, in any place. After this place, if you hear it any place, know that people come across this video. I am Chief Analyzer. Miro Africa. Look into the affairs of Africans. Analyze it very well. Look the GDP of those countries and what are they producing? Nothing that will be beneficial to Nigeria. Do they love Nigerians? Before we talk about free trade agreement, do we have free movement? Mm-mm. Do we have free visa? Mm-mm. Can Nigerians live in that country as soon as long as they like without applying for resident permit? No. Why rushing into free trade agreement? There are things that need to be ratified. Those countries, what are they producing that they will use to fool the Nigerian market? Because Nigeria is one of the strongest and the most toughest market any international company will penetrate. Nigeria looks like no man's area, but no business penetrate Nigeria like my mind. That's why I love that nation, you know. So, if you ask me personal, that what do I think on that free trade agreement? I know that those countries that are pushing for this free trade agreement doesn't have the money and the fund to feed themselves. But they are bringing out something that will cost billions of dollars to draft this free trade agreement and work towards it. It means there is a very big giant from behind that is sponsoring that thing for their own benefit. And the only country that I will point hand is China. China is the one financing this free trade agreement from behind. And the Chinese are not satisfied enough that their goods are being fooled into Nigeria. Nigerians are still controlling how many quantity of Chinese things that will fall into Nigeria so that our own domestic issues will be able to grow. Chinese are highly into agriculture. So if Nigeria jump into free trade agreement with African countries today, Chinese are now controlling most of those African countries are highly indebted into Chinese credit. And Chinese have already hijacked half of their government. It means Chinese will fool their country with Chinese product. And this people now will now transfer those products to Nigeria in the name of free trade agreement. Say no to it. Chinese are killing people with chemicals and uncontrolled rubbish. So the question now is, who is financing P2B and Atiku on this project? If Atiku and P2B are saying yes to this free trade agreement, it then means somebody is lobbying on the behalf of that free trade agreement, and that is China. And if you can talk to P2B and talk to Atiku, tell them I am here to bring them down if they still open their tongue and accept that free trade agreement. If they go in favor of free trade agreement, it then means they will fail and fail woefully. They want to poison the entire Nigerians. And I don't know why Anambra people so much love money in terms of buying and selling. Because P2B is like an import and exporter who want to fool Nigeria with all the whole Chinese rubbish. For him to accept such a thing, I am against it. So that matter, that one is, you know, is something that we should look into it. Whose interest? Who is going to develop the goods these people are going to bring in? You know, why should we rush into the free trade agreement? Why? We should emulate America. Nigeria is the largest consuming country after America, if you don't know it today. Nigeria is the largest consuming nation. Production, every part of the world are producing. Everybody's producing, even I. My agriculture project is moving in Nigeria. Poultry farm is growing heavily. All of us are producing. Who is the largest consumer? After United States, you count on Nigeria. You don't count on China. China is the largest exporter of already made or coupled product in their country. They are the largest exporter. Germany is one of the largest exporters in Europe. Who is the largest consumer? Nigeria and United States. So if you know the power in consuming of goods, then you will know that you can nail and play the music that the Chinese and other part of the world will dance. So on those issues, I don't think that there are more things that I would like to add or that may chip in or I may chip in in all these things. So the only thing I would like to add in terms of to finish up this project is or this program is about the leaders, those coming out for political positions. Those coming out for political position in Nigeria. The youths, the younger ones, are not talking about, they are seeing the current government disappointing them to the largest score. This current government is not working. Everybody's crying, people are complaining. But we are still stepping in to make another mistake. In the next 4 years or next election, if Atiku took over, after 2, 3 years, Atiku will still be in the same category with Buhari. And the same problem will keep on going. Moghalu, our brother, former deputy Central Bank governor, well, Leonard, only that he keeps on advertising himself in BBC, CNN, in the in those big platforms, forgetting that today nobody they watch those programs. People are now watching the alternative media, that is Miro Africa and other ones around. Our people keep on making mistakes. For those that will participate in election, I would advise you to leave Atiku. Either you vote in the current government back to finish what they start, or you go for Moghalu, our brother, the youngest, or one of the youngest aspirant. So that's the other advice I have for you. Thank you for listening to Miro African Television. Thank you for visiting my page, Miro Africa. Please like my page, share it, and comment. If there are places that I need to do some correction, just let me know. If there are areas that need some amendment, put it in writing. I am your presenter, Zebedi Ejike. Thank you, God bless you, and bye-bye for now. Oh, before I forgot, Merry Christmas to all in advance. In Europe, in German, we do celebrate Christmas on the 24th night. That's when Germans celebrate their Christmas. And we, the African people, we will still celebrate our own on the 25th December. So I will use this opportunity to tell you Happy Christmas in advance and also Happy New Year. Remain blessed. Maybe I will still do video on New Year live, where I would love to pray with all our followers, our subscribers, praying together, thanking God, the Almighty, for making us to see that day. Please, have you gotten your turkey? You haven't. Why not? Look for one. If you're in Nigeria, in Imo State, I have a very large farm, poultry, well taken care of, well treated to the European standard. I may give you a number that you may call. Get yourself one powerful chicken for you and your family back home, you know? So let me give you the number to call if you would like to test the chicken from my own poultry farm. So the number to call to reach is +234. Oh, somebody said that I should not give it up. But I will show you the link on Facebook where you go and talk to him directly, my manager in Nigeria, taking care of it. We are producing our own feed, making sure that the chickens are well treated and well taken care of. So, thank you. Remain blessed. God bless you.